David Marks, MBE, the architect of the British Airways I-360, has sadly died after a long illness. David was a world-class architect and a man of amazing vision and integrity who transformed skylines and cities. Together with his wife Julia Barfield, they created a legacy of lasting landmarks which inspired the imagination. These include the London Eye and the Treetop Walkway at the Botanical Gardens at Kew, as well as Brighton's iconic British Airways I-360. David was awarded an MBE in the Queen's New Year's Honours List in 2000 and was given a special commendation for outstanding achievement in design for business and society by the Prince Philip Designers Prize in the same year. His vision will continue to offer inspiration and delight to future generations. Now I'm joined here in our studio by Latest TV's Bill Smith. Bill, David had an incredible career, well known across the world. How well respected do you think he is?
He's one of the most respected architects that there is in the world. You know, he built the main paid-for tourist attraction in the UK, the London Eye. He's now done the same in Brighton. The Kew Gardens walkway. He's just been working on an extraordinary mosque in Cambridge. His record really in the last 30, 40 years is unrivaled, in my view.
It seems like a lot of his creations and buildings, they're a lot to do with interaction, aren't they? He really wants to engage with people.
He's always been like that, always, you know, from when he was young. He wants to please the public, he wants to provide pleasure and joy into this world, and that's indeed what he has done with Julia, his wife.
That's really, you know,
for 35
thing.
Years, I think they were married. He said he couldn't put into words how much he loved her. He brought that same love to architecture and to what he did. Every building that he built, he left something behind. For instance, at the London Eye, you've got Jubilee Gardens, which was, you know, caused because of all the money that he insisted went to build that. He was chair of the Waterloo sort of rebirth societies as well. Everywhere he's gone, even when he was young and he was a squatter in London in Stockwell, you know, he made sure the park opposite was beautifully and architecturally designed and and left that behind too.
That's brilliant. So obviously he was down in Brighton building the I-360 and you were quick to get in touch when he came down, weren't you?
I was a supporter. I think Brighton has always, in the last few years, it's very cool, as you know, but it's lacked family things, you know, family stuff. And I saw that it could be a great attraction for families, just like the piers were. He was a great admirer of Eugenius Birch, the guy who built the West Pier, the architect behind it. And I think that's exactly what David and Julia did with the I-360. They built a vertical pier. It's doing really well. And he was great with the people who criticised him. There were quite a lot of critics. It's little known, but when he started the London Eye, nobody would back him at all. There were just as many critics, more. And he had to remortgage his house to back his own vision, which he did.
So he's very much personally invested in all of his projects.
He was very personally invested, right up to the latest one, which is a very modern English mosque in Cambridge.
Oh, it's really, really impressive stuff. He's really left an indelible mark here on the city of Brighton, hasn't he?
He's left an indelible mark in many places, not least Brighton, of course. That's, you know, our home city. I'm so pleased that he came here. His son, Benjamin, is following in his tradition, won an award last year, an architectural award. I think the Marks Barfield will go on. His legacy is enormous.
Well, thanks for joining us today, Bill.
I just wanted to lastly say that I think he is one of the most amazing people I've ever met. I don't often I'm known for my trademark caps, but I take my cap off to David Marks.
Absolutely.
Everybody loves to go up high. It's almost an innate human desire to get up high and enjoy the view, to see the landscape stretched out beneath you like a carpet. It's a beautiful sight.
There's nothing of this height that is this thin, and it is that feature which really drives the design.
We've sort of got the band back together, really, who did the London Eye. We've got a fantastic team of very, very skilled engineers and contractors all coming together to make something that's never been done before. We're absolutely thrilled. It's been 10 years in the making, and finally we've got something very tangible to show for it.
I think that we will see an ongoing increase in tourism, and the I360 coming to Brighton has only got to be good news.
You're just starting to get a sense of what the height will be. If you can imagine all these cans that we can see here laid up all together going up into the sky, it's going to be an incredible sight when it's finished.
I'm from this area and I think that the I360 will be fantastic.
I think it's a wonderful landmark. I think something good for Brighton, really.
The fluidity of the glass. You can look at the renders and the drawings, but not until you see it in reality do you realize how amazing it really is.
What we're doing is we're reconstructing two new toll booths, and they'll be sitting at the same location as the previous toll booths.
Connections with Brighton and with Sussex. Obviously, just up the road at Gatwick, we're flying 67 destinations around the world. So many of our staff live in this area, so many of our customers come from this area. It's just a really natural fit.
Tell you how lucky we feel.